This is the final in our prisoner special featuring Val Lehman, Joy Westmore and Annie Phelan. There will also be a special guest, Stephanie Moore from Positive Women, and also Tabitha Turlington will be sitting in. Now, there will be a special competition on Squeal tonight, so watch out for that. Also, the Royal Children's Hospital Foundation invites you, your family and friends on a spectacular sunset cruise. The Lady Lindemann will depart from Lynn Dock on the Yarra River at 5 p.m. on Sunday, February 27. You'll enjoy a balmy summer's evening in this idyllic river setting. Food, fun and frivolity are included in the cost price of $75. Dress code is nautical. As numbers are limited, please call Rhonda on 9568 8116, that's 9568 8116, to make a reservation for your party and avoid disappointment. And stay tuned for Bent TV.
Channel 31 wishes to advise viewers that our next program is classified MA and contains adult themes, medium-level course language, sexual references. Repeating, our next program is classified for mature adults.
This program is proudly sponsored by DT's Hotel, where every colour of the rainbow drinks, corner of Hyatt and Church Streets, Richmond.
Well, welcome. Here we are. Welcome to Squeal.
Yay!
It's amazing to be having a couple of celebrities in the studio with this audience. Normally there's like a person with his dog out there. Anyway, I'm Peter. Welcome. We have a cavalcade and avalanche of people with us today. We have the lovely Sue Ridge and Tabitha Turlington with us today.
In the
children's table, on the kids' table. There they are.
Yeah, always have those relative parties with
the kids. There they are. And we also have with us from Positive Women, the coordinator of Positive Women, Stephanie Moore.
Yay!
And we also have, along with our lovable regulars, Paul and Michael.
Hello.
Hello.
We're continuing our prisoner fest with Annie Phelan and Joy Westmore. And we also...
I'm starting to feel like a regular.
I know.
It's going to be shocking when we go back to doing
this. Oh, I'll come back.
You can ignore Melrose place, like, you know, with Amanda and Spe- you know, how she's always a special guest.
Oh, yeah, I can keep coming back.
And we're not going to tell you who, but we have for the very last segment, am I looking at the right camera? Who knows? A very, very, very special guest.
Yes.
There you go. That's right.
We're not
I'm not going to say anything
any
else.
Clues,
that's right.
It's like royalty.
Mmm. And we're not talking princess with either.
Oh, I think that might have been a queen.
Oh, behave, will you? Anyway.
Lay it on the line. No, they'll have to wait.
see.
Anyway, so we've got the people from the people. There's some lovely cast members from Prisoner again. So we're going to ask some people. We're going to ask some more questions about Prisoner.
Yeah. Cool. Okay. Well, of course. Can I just go? Yeah, Joy, I'm going to say welcome, Joy. I've been here twice before, darling. Take it away. You're going to be one of our guests on the night, of course.
Of course.
At the show.
Absolutely.
Now, here we've got big posters. Here we've got everything. The Prisoner unlocks the gate for AIDS, which is a Prisoner 21st birthday. It is 21 years since Prisoner started.
We're so old.
On the 26th, that is this coming Saturday, you only have really 5 days to go.
Oh, my goodness. So
five days to go. Ticketek or on the night. You can get tickets at the Forum Theatre.
Forum Theatre?
7:30 onwards. It will, and I can say this now without thinking, oh no, is this false advertising? It will be the greatest number of Prisoner actors ever gathered together, ever, ever, ever. We have at least 130 now, I have replies. And everyone goes, were there that many in it? There were thousands were in it, actually.
How many? Do you really know?
Oh, I haven't counted, but you know those great big packets that you get of computer paper.
Yeah,
it is one of those, and there are about 10 to 12 names on every page. So work that out. Mm. I haven't had time to count them, but I will. But the interesting thing is that there's more men than women, believe it or
is
not.
That right?
Yep.
But they played little bits.
Yeah, yeah. The men came in.
Oh, we were very.
I mean, we did have male
prisoners,
guest roles, and we had three male prisoners.
Living at Wentworth.
Well, one of them was in my bed.
I know.
What I had my first ever love scene on screen in a show about women prisoners with a male.
Oh, oh, we worked that one
out. Bit of a conjugal, wasn't
it? Yeah, conjugal. And you'll be there, by the way.
And I got my first screen kiss.
Did you? Oh. And yours, that was from Ernie Bourne?
It was.
I was going to say, was it from a prisoner or
from the girl? Ernie Bourne will be there. We've got some fantastic people coming and a great lineup of entertainment, too. We've got two big music segments. We've got the RAAF band, Force 10 band, the Massed Prisoner Choir. Now, this is a
first.
That's
special.
Every prisoner actor that is there on the night is part of the prisoner choir. We are
what
going
are you
to
sing?
Do. Well, what did you think we're going to sing?
There will be tears,
but we and the very special guest, of course, for the choir will be Alan Taswell, who wrote.
Yes. What about the girl that originally sang it?
No, she's up in Brisbane.
Oh, Lynn Hamilton. I remember
Lynn Hamilton. We haven't been able to track Lynn Hamilton down.
Oh, Lynn, if you're watching.
Chance, if anyone knows where Lynn Hamilton is, she has 5 days to get on.
Yeah,
and,
we've got some.
So it's going to be a great. And it's a great night, so great entertainment. And also, too, on top of that, we've got wonderful things for auction. We might talk about that a bit later.
Yeah, because
we're going to... Because he's the host, you see.
The power's gone straight to my head. Yeah,
Go for it.
Okay, we have some footage coming up. Oh, 10 seconds. Oh. Buzz McMillan on Squeal from last week. Then we're going to see her in A Prisoner Days.
Oh.
Yes, that's going to be exciting. So here we go.
A bit of before and after.
Yes, before and after. Well, after and before, actually.
Technical.
And there we go. Okay, we're still here. There you go.
Stretch.
Okay. So,
Babs
was Cass Parker.
I've got a trivia.
You got trivia?
Yeah. I was reading on a prison website the other day, and you know the credits, the mugshot credits at the beginning? How many stars appeared, how many characters appeared in the mugshots throughout the whole series?
Oh, that is a trivia. That is. And you know the answer.
I do.
You know the
2012?
Sorry?
2012?
Oh, very close.
Yeah.
25. So there you go.
Wow.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And there was only ever a side shot used of Lizzie. There's never a front on.
Trivia. This whole big party started as a small trivia night. It's grown to this amazing and massive thing. Which, I have to add, of course, is seeing as we haven't cut to anything.
No,
I'll keep talking.
Oh, we're going to get this on. Is it ready? Oh, we're ready to go. Okay, we're going to go. Yeah, we're going to go with the footage of Babs after and before.
I'll stop talking.
Yeah, you're actually maybe just want to keep talking. Oh,
maybe
you just have to keep talking.
There's Babs.
I checked,
mate.
What a fool she was.
She got
by
the camera.
You will all know and remember as Frankie Doyle.
Yeah, of course.
On the original episodes of Prisoner.
Yes, Frankie.
So I'm very, very thrilled indeed to be working with Carol again on a new play.
First thing to remember, Parker, is that this is not Barnhurst. We run a very tight ship here.
Yeah,
Yeah, it's real nice too.
Okay, make your bed. Be quick about it.
Freak's probably given our tucker to her mates too.
Yes.
Oh, g'day. Cass Parker. You my new cellmates?
Oh, well, pleased to meet you, Cass. I'm Pixie Mason and this is Lizzie Birdsworth.
Pleased to meet you both.
Is this your first time in prison?
No, I'm from Barnhurst. But I've gotten a bit of bother up there, so they shipped me out. I don't mind, but seems an okay sort of joint.
Barnhurst. Our best mate's just gone there. B. Smith.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I heard she'd showed up. Hey, top dog round here, wasn't she?
Yeah. Best mate anybody could ever have. You're sitting on her bed.
Oh, geez, sorry. But, you know, I mean, that's where they put me. Look, I don't want any strife. One of yous can swap if you want.
No, it's all right. You look as though you could fill it. She looks pretty tough. Just the sort we need to fix those bastards.
Can I just say, before we cast the suit reach, the entire studio was silent during that. That was fantastic. Anyway,
great actor Babs McMillan is.
She was pretty damn good.
I want her to be working
more. And wasn't Sheila gorgeous?
Sheila was wonderful. And Judy McBurney, beautiful. Go to the desk.
Okay, we're going over this lovely suit. Off we go.
Oh, thank you very much. This is the lovely Susie Sully here. The very pretty Tabby Kite. We do have a little bit of news. I'll go first with my bit of news, actually, Tabby. World Pride 2000. Hundreds and thousands of gays and lesbians will descend on the Vatican, on Vatican City, for Worldwide Pride Day, June the 28th to 8th of July. Also, thousands of Catholic pilgrims will be in the same city at the same time, Doc. And the Pope, unfortunately, is not very happy about that.
Oh. But he'll have the best frocks.
Yes, he looks lovely too. How about you, Tabina?
Well, Suzanne, this one actually is a little bit different. Olivia Newton-John serenaded the Pope at the Vatican in Rome this week.
Really?
She sang the Judy Garland song Somewhere Over the Rainbow, Pope Must Fly, in front of good people, mainly the sick and handicapped. Which you have to sing for them as well. The Pope is happy once again. So
let's hear it for the Pope.
And also, Stu, I must point out, I don't know about you, but with star treatment, of course, Jerry Seinfeld needs to have racing car magazines in his dressing room. Michael Jackson, fresh white flowers.
Lovely.
Probably Matthews now, too. Elton John, no female staff allowed on the hotel floor.
Oh,
really? Well, Shania Twain, vegan soup and egg-free food dishes. What do you like in your dressing room when you're, you know, flying around?
A nice copy of the paper and half an hour on the toilet, that was.
There you go.
Quite nice for the old Susie.
Yeah, lovely.
What do you like?
I just like hair care, you know, products in cosmetic surgery magazines.
Yeah. A quick dip and tuck and all that sort of thing.
That was lovely, thanks for that. We're going to have to cut off right now and we're going to go to a break. And we can find out more about what Tabitha and Sue like in the privacy of their own dressing rooms after this break.
I'm still here. Baby, one more time, because I can't get the memories up off of my mind. It's just the way that you do me, the way I do you. And when we can you feel it too? I know you can, bet you can, so you can. I'm the man. Got me.
Yeah, I'm doing it.
Here we are. We're back. Welcome back. We have still got the lovely women from Prisoner with us, and of course, lovely. I keep going to call you different names. Stephanie from Positive Women. We have got, I don't know why. Here's Doreen. Yes, we've got the people from prison here because of the auction that's going to be held 26th of February, which is next Saturday, isn't it?
Yeah, it's coming Saturday.
Yes, it's coming. We've got the
thing. The auction at the Party Forum Theatre, 8 o'clock, ticket check or on at the door.
And there you go. Days to go?
Five! Is that right? After tonight, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, so five!
Exactly. Yeah. Ring up and you can meet your favourite prisoner cast member. You can
out of about 130 of them, and Joy Westmore is one of them!
Yeah. Nice segue! Now, Joy, you were, of course, Officer Barry.
I was, and my name was Joyce.
Joyce, Officer Joyce Barry.
Which used to confuse everybody no end, whether they called me Joyce, whether they called me Joy, so it didn't matter.
Didn't matter, you didn't care.
Didn't matter, no.
So when did you join the cast?
I joined the cast, actually, in episode about 60. My agent rang up and said, do you want to do 2 days on prisoner? Certainly, I said. And I went out and I did a couple of OB days, and, outside broadcast days.
Thank you.
And then they asked me back every now and then, and then I would be in for a couple of weeks, just tiny little bits, and then.
Well, did they ask you back, do you think, because you were a hard screw, or?
Well, I thought I was always renowned as a big and a good screw.
Good screw.
A lot of people have said that about Joy.
Go on.
Gentle screw, I was. Actually, I think I got sillier as the series went on.
Well, you got tamer, I think. Tabitha
do you?
Was saying that before, weren't you?
Tabitha, is that right? I was just normal.
At the beginning, you were sort of a bit, you were down the line, but as
right.
You got on, you got all giggly and silly.
Well, that was because they wanted a fool of an officer who let all the prisoners out and all the wicked people in. They'd say, I'm here to see, I'd say, all right, come in. Oh, all right, you can go. People had to escape, and it was always Joyce that did it.
Oh, that's lovely. And did you have much say into your character? Like, did you say, like, I want to be nicer or I want to...
No. I just think they... I had worked in comedy before and I think they just thought that I probably could lend a bit of lightness to the situation. Mind you, Ernie Bourne and I, when we got married, got pretty raunchy.
Yeah.
Oh.
We kissed, my first screen kiss.
Now, what was that like?
Oh, we did well.
Yeah?
We did well.
Did you take after take after?
Well, I left my husband, who was very disappointed, I'm sure, because I said he died, but I don't think he did, not in real life. And then I fell in love with the cook, Ernie Bourne.
Ooh.
Yeah, and then I became Mrs.
Pringle.
That's right. They were saying before.
Everything.
Absolutely.
I used to shoot up prisoner.
You know what?
I was in grade 2 when it first started, and I was just addicted from the very first time.
Actually, my dear, she remembers more about it than I do, and probably more than you do too.
Oh, I think you remember more than I do. And I find that the fans actually. I wish I could speak.
That's the heat. That's
being
the heat.
Connected with this AIDS fundraiser that we're doing, and I'm just finding people coming. Oh, and like you, all you guys are amazing.
Yes.
All you lot out there, all of Bent TV and Joy FM, and they all and they say, oh, and what about when? And I think. Oh, yeah.
But they don't realise, sweetheart, that we used to learn it for a week and then it'd have to go
and we'd have to
get the next week into
our
heads.
Yeah, because you've got to clear the brain and get the next line.
That's right.
So we'd go mad otherwise.
We've got some... Oh, now we're going to footage
in 1 minute.
In 1 minute. When did the call come to say, would you like to do it full time? And was that like, yes? Like,
oh, yes.
Average weekly income has just gone up.
Yes, we had 4 kids and we had to educate them and it was... bloody handy. That's
amazing. Wonderful.
Oh, yes. The pennies helped.
A lot of children were educated because their mothers, and sometimes their fathers, were in prisoner.
That's right.
I mean, Elspeth Ballantyne.
That's right.
I think who, Officer Meg Morris, who's over on the wall looking over
the bears.
And she has 2 beautiful children. You have beautiful children. And
I have 3 grandchildren.
And
almost 4.
Yeah. Oh, almost 4.
Almost 4.
Well done.
Yes.
And Val's 2 girls.
Yep.
And... just a lot of...
Well, there weren't a lot of jobs, regular jobs like that for women on Australian television.
Still not, Dan.
Still not.
Well, that's true.
I mean, Annie's...
Newsreaders?
No. Oh, yes.
Okay, we got the footage now of Officer Barry doing something with liquor.
Wow.
Oh, with the free.
Yo-ho! Ho! And a bottle of...
Birdsworth. You don't want to advertise. I quit drinking that stuff.
Well, I'm going to have a quick nip, Miss Ferguson. Otherwise, I'm announced gay.
What?
Oh, God, they're not coming here, are they?
Stay put and not a word.
Are you not going to leave us here by ourselves, are you, Miss Ferguson?
Shut up and do as you're told.
Oh, glory. It's you, Miss Ferguson. Oh, you gave me such a fright. Oh, my heart, it leapt right into my feet.
Likewise. You must have heard the noises too.
What? Oh, yes, it seemed to be coming from in there. I thought I'd better take a quick look.
Oh, it was probably me you heard crashing about.
Oh.
I nearly got one of them.
One? What are you talking about?
Rats.
Oh, really?
Yeah, I think there's a family in there. I saw one. Huge, big animal. Oh, teeth like razor blades.
Oh, teeth.
You want to help me track him down?
Oh, no, thanks. No, prisoners I sometimes know about, but rats, well, I'll leave that to the experts. Oh, no offence. I was so young.
And prissy.
She didn't do comedy for nothing.
That was very funny.
That was great.
Now, well,
you see, a fool. Joyce was a fool. But nice.
Cute,
but you
yeah.
mean, I mean, that's what makes drama, doesn't
that's
it?
That's right.
The good, the bad, the funny, the sad.
And speaking of the freak, our own freak, Paul, is wearing...
Oh!
The freak's name badge.
This is part of the auction at the prisoner party. Maggie Kirkpatrick, who you just saw on the screen there, has donated this. This is the freaks ID tag.
Hey.
Maggie, of course, will be there on the night. She's arriving a bit late because she's in a play at the moment.
Yeah.
But she will be there. And also, Maggie, and here's, how's this for a segue?
Oh.
Maggie Kirkpatrick was in the London production of the musical.
Good segue.
Prisoner musical. Good segue over to the host.
Look,
who
look
is wearing the Prisoner Cell Block H Live on Stage
look.
T-shirt.
Wow.
Now, that belongs to David Gretsch, has donated that for the auction. And
that's
I reckon
right.
there's not many of those in Australia no. at all.
And I'm not even going to wash it, so it's going to have a couple of extra bucks for it.
And also, from the musical, Peter Pinney and Don Batty, who both wrote The Prisoner, actually, and they wrote The Prisoner musical. This was on the West End, by the way, with Lily Savage.
Oh, lovely. Yeah.
Lily Savage was in it, and yes. Maggie Kirkpatrick, and lots of English actors. Mm-hmm. And of some great music, Maggie got to do a really big number with the glove.
Oh.
And Don Batty and Peter Pinney wrote it, and Peter Pinney, who lives in America now, he has donated to the auction the poster of the musical, one of the songs, his original manuscripts of the song, and the CD of the musical. And that none of that's available in Australia, so that's pretty good. But you have to pay your $75
that's right.
at Ticketek
that's
or
right.
at the forum on the night to get in, to buy, to be at the auction.
And I'll
days?
Tell you
days?
Something. I met
5 days.
I met someone the other day at the Green Room Awards
yes.
who was in Prisoner, and she thought she had to pay $75 too. I said, no. If you're in prison,
yes, but she has to let me know.
I know. That's what I said.
Who was it?
Oh.
You can't remember. Oh, dear.
We said anyway. For it to come along.
But that's all right. If the actors have got $75,
come along.
Let them pay.
Not
really.
A lot of actors pay.
We're going to go from one drag queen to another. That was a sort of really bad segue from Lily Savage. Over to Sue. She's going to talk a bit about what you did for Fashion Week.
Thank you very much. This is the newsy with Susie. This is the news in brief.
Ah.
That's why she got a gold Logie. Yeah,
like you do crap like that.
No, that was actually with Myers.
With Myers?
Yeah.
So what were you doing with that?
I was...
Sorry.
I was eating. No, I was modelling the fantastic thong dress from Priscilla.
Really?
I saw that on the telly.
Yeah. Yes. It was 100 moments of fashion.
Wow.
100 years.
It was in the paper too, wasn't it?
I certainly was, love.
The thong dress.
I've got 100 copies at home if you want. And video.
Have you been practicing your autograph?
Oh, I certainly have.
Was it a comfy dress to wear?
Sorry?
Was it a comfy thing to wear?
Oh, it's crap.
Oh,
it was lovely. It was rubber. It was rubber. It was thongs that stretched and pulled and...
So something showed, something didn't?
A bit of this, a bit of that.
Yeah.
A bit hung out the back. Did you get that? When you wear thongs.
Thong marks, you're like you took a 20.
Well, they're just having a private moment.
They're having a private moment.
It was lovely anyway. It was lovely nonetheless.
Did you meet any fashion glitterati? Did Naomi turn up?
Well, no, unfortunately. So I walked in there and I said, I'm not wearing this. I'm not wearing that. Only because I couldn't fit into it.
So they gave me. I think that's really nice now they're using the fuller figured models to do that.
Thank you very much, Tabitha. That's lovely.
Thank you very much. Yeah.
Susie Nicole Smith.
She's pretty. Shut up.
Yeah. She's lovely.
Lucy.
You know, Lucy.
And also a real blonde.
Did
Sorry?
You see
also
they,
a real blonde.
They brought out, the Australian Olympic people brought out the Olympic outfits that they're going to wear, that the volunteers are going to wear.
Oh, yes, and... Oh, disaster God. Again.
I was like, think Ken Doan. Think Ken Doan. What is it with Australia?
What is it? Why do we always get it so wrong?
I don't know. They just think... We need lots of colour and splash. So,
and it's either that or this dreadful. What was the year they came out in those grey? What is the matter with green and gold? I'm sorry. I
exactly.
Think, to me, that is what our. Let's settle on some Australian colours.
Just anything that doesn't involve. Ken Doan?
Yeah. I mean, careful, there might
Jenny.
Be Ken Doan.
Oh, yeah, allegedly, yes. I mean, yeah.
Jenny Kay.
One man's meat is another man's
poison. That's right.
Pretty cool.
You'd be Jenny nice.
Martha, oh, I have to, yes, we must, I mean, I'm sure there's people out there who do love Ken Doan, and that's lovely. We have a photo.
That's from a mental institution.
Yes, although my photo did.
This is a bottle of port. We
have a Ken Doan jumper back in the early 80s.
Hold it still for the woman.
Oh, sorry, sorry. This is a lovely photo from the magazine Focus. Oh, how am I going? There we go.
Yeah, it's not too bad.
There we go. This is a couple of weeks ago. We've got the lovely
she's
cast of prisoner there.
Yeah, we've got Babs McMillan and Leslie Baker.
And Babs McMillan
and Leslie Baker.
That's
we'll
right.
All be there
and who
tonight.
Is that?
Who's that?
Oh. Who's that?
Oh, that's some cheesy
yes.
Black.
And who's that?
You're fingering Susie.
Susie's finger.
Not many people have done that.
Hello. That's virgin territory, love.
Okay, 5 days to go.
Five days to go.
To the prisoner party, forum theatre.
That's right. You can wear this T-shirt. You can wear that badge. You can...
Bring your money. Spend it.
Kiss these lovely women
I
here.
Believe they're auctioning my old uniform.
Yes, they are. Yes. Yep, yes. They are.
Yes.
Hold it up again. And once again, it is open to the public.
Okay,
we'll say it again. Yes. We'll say it again. It is.
That's who it's for, because it's to raise money
for positive women.
Positive women in Bouverie Street. All the money is going to them.
Go and have a cup of tea, bye.
No.
Out there, and not forgetting the bent-friendly viewers either. I hope you're enjoying tonight's third prisoner invasion of Squeal. But for now, the weather. It'll be fine tonight and a few showers tomorrow, but a chance of a late thunderstorm. It'll be a humid day with fresh to strong northeast to northerly winds, and a top temperature of 31 degrees. Wednesday will be mainly fine and 30 degrees. Thursday will be fine and 28 degrees, with Friday fine and a hot 35 degrees. Well, that's it from this weather girl for now. And we'll see you again shortly. Enjoy.
Maureen, it's not that gay and lesbian Ben TV again. You know I've got a bad ticker.
Oh, shut up, Dizzy. This week they've got almost as many people as a cast of Prisoner.
Oh, dear. That was our special. Oh. That was lovely Miss Vic and our special AP, Stephen, doing their little Prisoner tribute from last week. How'd you find that?
Oh, breathtaking. Yeah. I'm lost for words. I've
got my teeth in this week. That's what the problem.
Now, there's a couple of things before we go on. Joy, you've not probably noticed that Joy has gone, but she will be back. She's gone to get our special guest.
Ooh. She's bringing up the royal carriage.
That's right. Ooh. Now, be quiet, everyone. Don't give it away. And also, we must say, we've forgotten to do this, we must say thank you to Grundy's for providing us with the footage. So, thank you, Grundy's. Love your work. That's great. Love your work.
And actually, Grundy's, I might say too, Grundy's have pitched in with four return airfares from Sydney to bring down four of the past members.
Fantastic. Look at you. There you go.
We asked them for 20, but they
got April 26.
And that can I say that's Judith McGrath.
Oh, yes.
Oh, God, she knows. Andy Anderssen, Les Diamond, coming down. Peter Tapano. Tracy Mann.
Tracy Mann.
Anna Ruby. And there's going to be lots of other people there. I'll tell you who's going to be there. Siggy Thornton and Terry Armstrong.
Siggy Thornton, oh my God.
They're going to be there. Lots of Neighbours people are going to be there. Not only Ian Smith, but not only prisoner people.
Anyway, we're going to get a bit serious for a moment. Stephanie Moore is with us from Positive Women. You are the coordinator of Positive Women.
That's right.
Yes.
That's right.
So, and this is, Positive Women is the reason this whole shebang is happening, really, isn't it?
That's right.
So, Positive Women, you don't really hear much about Positive Women in the media, gay or mainstream.
Otherwise, yes. No, you don't. I mean, I think that's, a lot of people find that quite amazing that there are women around with HIV AIDS. So, you know, we actually have, within the gay community, we've got quite a small profile. And one of the good things about the prisoner fundraiser and also another event that we're involved in is that we're going to be raising the profile of these women to let the people know that, you know, women do get HIV AIDS, that there is needs to be community awareness, there needs to be education, and we also need support, you know.
And it's a different kind of support.
Yeah, I mean, our women, most half the women have got kids.
Exactly.
Yeah. Maybe single parents.
So you need like... Yeah.
Also too, Stephanie, I would think that the problem with a woman who's HIV AIDS is the... Do you tell the community?
Yeah.
When you've got children, when you've perhaps got a partner...
That's right, Annie.
Is in a high-flying job, do you tell the school?
No. Those are the issues for the women. I mean, within the gay community, there's sort of a community within a community. Mm. But for our women, we're often very isolated and also on their own maybe, or maybe with a partner, but, you know, if they tell the school or the kids get sort of then stigmatised or discriminated against, you know.
Does that happen?
It has happened, yeah.
Well, Alicia was on last week, and she was still in school, I think, when her mother was diagnosed HIV positive. And she said it was good in the sense that her actual school, they got together an education program for the kids in the school.
Yeah,
and
which was great.
It was approached in a positive way, because that was my concern for her last week. Right. I said, did you... Because not that it matters how you get HIV, but her mother got it through transfusions.
Right. Mm-hmm.
But there is a stigma involved having HIV, and therefore kids also suffer.
And that's also why the women don't want to go out, and you know they're not as sort of open about their status as some of the other groups are. Yeah. So, you know, the Positive Women organisation is a really good support for them, where they can come and meet with other women to talk about the issues that are relevant to women, you know, I mean, gynecological issues, kids.
But it's good to meet someone who's got the same problem,
exactly. Get that support and not feel, you know, so isolated or so discriminated against or ashamed, embarrassed, guilty.
The thing that's too is that it's actually not just for positive women themselves, it's for positive women and their
family and their friends.
So it's a support group for the partners and the kids within that as well, which is really, really expensive, because the focal point of our conversation last week, and you said it's not, and it was Alicia as well that said it, it's not people dying of HIV.
It's
the people living with it that we've got to.
And that's one of the things that we're looking at addressing, you know, how do people live with AIDS? You know, what is it that people want to do that makes the quality of life? It's about the quality of life.
Well, that's what your slogan is, isn't it?
Says, you know, and that slogan came about as a result of, we've got a triathlon team, which is also on tomorrow down at Elwood, 7:45, if people want to get up early.
We actually go on, is that Sunday? Yes, go. That's okay.
That's all right.
Thank you
to everyone that went.
huge success.
Yeah, big turnout. Should have been there.
Yeah. And it was a result of I've lost my plot now. And they came up with that slogan, positively living life, you know?
Yeah. Because, yeah.
As opposed people... to just, you know, dying from the disease, but living.
And also, too, Stephanie, do you find, I found with helping to coordinate the prisoner party, which, of course, is an AIDS fundraiser, that's really the only reason we're doing it. Yeah. The reunion and a whole lot of us getting together and having a good time is really secondary to us getting together and raising money for AIDS.
Yeah.
And I forgot what I was going to say now. Oh, yes. Do you find that HIV/AIDS now is not in advertising parlance sexy anymore?
Yeah. Yeah.
It's like, been there, done that. What are they still whinging about, you know?
Yeah. But also,
and I'm finding that very difficult to cope with.
Yeah, it's a hard one. It's like passe or something.
Now,
We just have to go to Sue and Tabitha for some community news.
And a giveaway.
And a giveaway.
Yeah. Yeah.
Oh, thank you very much. And what a giveaway it is, too. What are we going to do, Tabby? We've got news everywhere. I'll just read this one out. This is... Ooh, I've dropped the thing. I hate that. You've got to read that for a second while I re-establish myself.
I wouldn't actually like to read out Margaret. It's far more important. Those who are out there, you're feeling isolated, you need advice. AIDS information, call, is that the gamma line?
Gamma, yes.
Gamma, as in gummy but with an A. So it's gamma line, 039-899-059 or 1-800-807-6600. I sound like I'm doing a telephone.
I was going to say thank you very much to the bisexual man.
And if there's any like confused Turkish or Greek boys, you can get my number, care of SQUEAL, okay? I'll help you. I'll confuse you any which way I know how. That's what I'm here for, I do community services.
I think that is about... Let's do our sponsorship things.
Well, can we do our giveaway, Susan?
Let's do the giveaway then.
It's a very exciting giveaway. Thank you, Susan. Together again for the very first time. It's a prisoner giveaway. That's right. That's what it is. Someone's donated a lovely ticket. Do you know who donated it?
Yes, that was donated by one of the union officials at MEAA.
So he's donated this ticket. So
yes.
All you need to do is ring up and answer a very simple question. That was, how was B. Smith killed in the Prisoner series? Answer that. First one through, he gets the question correct. Of course, the question was again. How did B. Smith die? It was a very tragic night at my house. I know I was crying. My mum came up with a hot Milo and a soggy Bicky. So you think that's who Rich has got the number for
I
you?
I do have the number here. It is 966-35902. You can all contact us on the email.
No, they've got to phone it through, Sue.
Why would you say want to email?
I don't care, they're not allowed.
We're not emailing them.
Only use the internet, of course, to look up Days and Alarms website.
Oh, stop it, we're not doing that.
Okay, we're going to the footage now. We've got some special footage. Thank you, Arthur.
We've
got some footage.
A couple of years younger, I wouldn't mind a slice myself.
Bastard.
Police will be here soon. Will you be okay?
Killed him. I didn't mean to.
I know. It was self-defense, Mum. Kay and I'll back you up on that.
He said some terrible things, Alan.
It's all right. It'll be okay, Mum.
I'll give you this.
Oh!
Whoa. Now there are some That was some pretty groovy footage of you there, eh?
Yeah, well, how slim and young and dark-haired was I. Now, this is one of the things in the auction that you'll get on the night. Morrie Fields, the beautiful, gorgeous late Morrie Fields.
Yes.
His son, Marty, is the MC for the night. There he is, strangling Maggie Kirkpatrick. And Val Gillet, of course, his wife, she's there. And she's actually going to be singing, too, on the night.
Oh, give me a bit
of flair. I'm trying to get rid of the flair there. But, of course, all of this is to do with raising money for
positive women
at Bloomsbury Street. And you can see the badge, and the badge is also up for auction. There you go.
There you go. So
wasn't it? He was opposite Len Murphy.
Len Murphy, that's right.
Oh, you're good.
Oh,
good.
She's very good.
She knows everything.
You are right at a trivia night. I want you at my table on a trivia night.
Tabitha's actually got the phone number that people need to call for positive women.
Yes, if you'd like more information in positive women in Victoria, of course, telephone number 03, you should know that because you're in Victoria, 9276 6918. And the address is, hi, PO Box 222, Pohan, Victoria 3181. Positive women, so more information. Please feel free to give them a call. They'll be only too happy to help.
And also, Stephanie, Alfred Hospital.
Yep.
If people didn't have their pens and papers, Alfred Hospital, just ask for positive women.
That's right. Yep. That's right. And,
you'd like to send any mail at all to the fantastic Squeal, this might be a lovely letter to myself, Tabitha, all the lovely boys up here. Please send them to care of Vent TV, PO Box 2248. Stop blowing my ear, thank you. Parang 3181. Thank you very much.
Lovely.
Yeah.
Now, next up, we're going to go for a break, but just remember, we've got that special guest, so
coming up.
Make your coffee, make
and
your
only
tea.
5 days to the
Five days.
Tickets on the night.
That's right, we need to help positive women and give positive women a call and help them, support them in practical ways.
If you can't come, send a donation via MEAA, the union.
Here we go. Come back.
All the knowledge you gained in the past, the others much younger than yourself. Brothers and sisters who were just like yourself, cause that cycle.
We're going to look just like these chocolates here. Anyway, we have a very, 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 very special guest with us today. Well, apart from the other very special guest, we have Val Lehman with us.
Yay!
There
are a lot of special guests.
Of course.
Yes. But you're the last segment special guest.
Oh, yes, I realise that. Yes, I know. I've always kept the best.
Exactly.
Does that mean you're available?
Always.
Is that the side for availability?
Actually, I usually have one on both sides.
Ah, okay. Just like cover all bases.
Yeah. She's wearing that at the auction. She is available for you. Okay, just remember that. So, Val, how
are
you?
If you can afford me.
If you can afford her. Where am I looking at? How are you, Val?
I'm really well. A bit warm.
Yeah. It's 38 degree days here.
Yep.
So what have you been doing?
40 degrees in the studio. 45 degrees, 50 degrees.
What have you been up to?
What have I been up to? We're promoting this mostly.
Oh, what is that?
I've been doing millions of interviews. What is that?
Tell us about that.
Well, this huge prisoner bash we're having on February the 26th at the Forum Theatre to raise money for AIDS charity, Positive Women. Positive Women.
Ta-da!
And the tickets are available at Ticketek.
And on the night.
And on the night.
Yes, on the night.
And you can buy tickets at the door, of course. You're going to get the chance, you fans out there, a prisoner, of getting close up and personal with an awful lot of prisoner stars. More than have ever been in one room at a time. That's scary, isn't it? I'm terrified.
Are you kind of excited about catching up with people again?
Yes, I am. I quite like to get together with the girls. Yes, it's good fun.
Do you do it often? It's like every 10, 5 years, it's like a prisoner.
She hasn't been here.
I did it a few times in England, actually.
Oh, you've been in London, haven't you?
Yes, I've been. Well, not in London.
Oh, England.
England, yes. England. And I did a tour with Sheila Florence and Amanda Muddleton and Carol Burns, for instance. Oh, that was a lot of fun.
So, what was it? What was the tour of fans?
Personal appearances, being interviewed on stage, and some music and entertainment and what have you, and the prisoner fans coming along. And then we did a video, which will be for sale, too.
That the UK fans are bringing over,
Of the actual event. So, and the money for that goes to the same charity. So,
which is positive move.
And there is this auction. I am going to be an auctioneer.
Oh!
Yes, after the night.
And, well, don't think you could force the price up a bit.
Well, I've had a bit of experience.
I told you that I'm $10.
What was that you bid for? Oh, right, okay. And we've got so many interesting things to auction off, memorabilia, that you'll never get your hands on again. And the girls have given up. Well, not only the girls, there are a few male members of the cast we let in. But they've given up their own personal bits and pieces to auction.
Yeah. Mm. We've got that up there. What's that? That's
that is the door prize, Val. We are now having a lucky ticket door prize. Wow. Which will be given out later in the night. So that, and I've just realised that reads Marina. Marina Jonathan.
Oh, right.
Who was one of our sort of long-term NSs with a few words.
That's right.
So often.
I remember.
Gorgeous.
Yes.
Gorgeous. She's coming. She'll be there.
Great.
But that's now the door prize. But Joy, your uniform down there. That's
really?
Yep. That actually said, we're not joking, it says Officer Barry on the tag. And we didn't put it on, it was there.
I tell you what I'm bringing along for the night. Do you remember those khaki things we used to wear when we were outside?
Oh yeah.
I've got one of those.
Fantastic.
So... It's a lovely ensemble.
But also too, there's not just the auction that Val's doing. We're having the silent auction as well. So don't think you've got to have a lot of money. You'll be able to pick up stuff for about $5. We've got fan cards with a lot of scripts. A lot of actors have donated their scripts.
Are you going to sing or something like that?
Oh, no, there's not enough money in the world.
But
Annie's going to sing, aren't you?
Yeah, I'm singing. And
there's a lot of singing at the beginning.
Okay.
A little something.
Oh, yes, there's the massed choir.
Mm.
I have to buddy in. We've got some footage of you later on. I've got to. It's my job as a host. I have to. It's my job. We have some footage of you as B, but we just wanted to say, have you got much... Where is it coming up? Okay. What's it like?
You lied.
We have in 1 minute's time, there you go. What's it like being remembered? Because even people that don't watch Prisoner know of the top dog. What's it like being remembered?
Well, I guess if I had a wish list, very early in my life, would you like to be remembered for something? I would have said yes. and that says you're too young to choose what it would be.
Oh,
I so I guess it's better than not being remembered for anything.
It is.
Absolutely. And people are usually very, very nice. Oh, used to. Because they don't come... Sweet and polite to me, I'm sweet and polite back.
That's so they don't come up to you and say, you're a bitch. And
no.
I can't ever imagine anyone doing that.
I thought people would be actually very cross with my character when the show first started. They're going to hate me. The things I did in episode one.
Yeah.
But no, they were right behind her. She should have killed her husband, and B and B should have put Lynn, thing in the thing because she deserved it.
Absolutely. But it was, I think, as hard and as vicious as the character B was, there was that side with Debbie and everything.
Well, I don't think she was vicious.
Everyone.
Okay, I have to interrupt. We got.
She was strong.
Is that right? In 10 seconds' time? So we're going to have a look. Sorry, I didn't mean to interrupt. Well, I did actually. We're going to have a look at
some footage. Who do you think you are, the host or something?
Well, you're right. I'm going to put it. Here we go.
You must be B. Smith. I'm Sandy Edwards.
Yeah, I sort of guessed that.
I hear the press is usually your job.
That's right. Any objections?
No, thanks. I've heard too much about you.
Well, you can always try if you're feeling lucky.
After what Mari Winter told me about you, I'd have to be a dill. She said you're the top dog. That's good enough for me.
Mari Winter, eh? How long are you in for?
22 years. Or so they say. But I'll be out long before that.
What a skate.
Oh, that's for mugs. Oh, I've got a much better way. And it's all legal. It's all in the way you handle the screws. You see, you come in here and make out you're a right troublemaker. Then over the next few years, you settle down. Play the game. Let them think they've rehabilitated you. Then they put you up for parole, and you show them you've seen the error of your ways. And they let you out. Then you're back on the outside and you pick up where you left off. Do you want your press back now?
No, thanks. You can have it for a while. I prefer it working up in the library. It's a lot more peaceful. And besides, I'm fed up with fighting other people's battles for them.
Exit lines.
I just love it. Like, you know, walked in, it's just like, she's here. That was so cool. But you just know, like, how was it being the cool character? Like,
well, I tell you before about being cool, I did an interview yesterday, and my grandson, who lives in Brisbane, came along with my daughter, who incidentally is played B. Smith's daughter, Debbie.
Oh, my God.
And three guys from a pop group called Taxi Ride.
Yeah.
And said, oh, no, we're putting a family. And looked at my 7-year-old grandson and said, your grandmother is so cool. And he just sort of went, what is wrong? He's never thought of me as being cool.
No, they don't. He'll realise when he's, 20, 30. Oh, she was cool. Now, Stephanie has something for you.
Oh, well.
Yes.
I don't know if you know that the rose is the international symbol of positive women.
No, I didn't.
I didn't know that.
No,
that's
fine. Good. Yeah,
so, I'd like to present you on behalf of Positive Women, BTV and the gay and lesbian community and the transgender community, a rose. And a melted chocolate kiss.
Have a bit of sludge.
Lovely.
And really, thanks for everybody for all your efforts. It's been great.
Yes, thank you.
Yeah.
Oh, thank you. Thank you, Steph.
Thank you, Steph.
The milkshake.
Thanks, Stephanie. Thank you.
Can I just say on behalf of Oz Show Biz Cares and Positive Women and Bouverie Street and the Union and all the prisoner actors, thanks to Bent TV, you have been fantastic.
Yeah.
Buy your tickets.
Come on, guys. Come and see us in the flesh. Yeah.
Get them on the door at the
night.
Yeah, get them on the door at the night.
From one doyen, is that the word? The doyen of the scene to another scene. So, Rich, how are you over there?
Oh, how are you,
Doug? I'm fine, Alice.
This is the newsie with Susie again. I just had to say
that. Fantastic.
But the biggest news of all on the strip at the moment is the lovely Tabitha Turlington's nose.
Oh, my God.
Lovely. Can anyone have a look at that nose?
Look at that.
It costs a lot of money. Now, I just wanted to ask
her. How much?
Is it firm?
Yeah, it's still actually a little bit numb underneath there. That's fine, though, for the moment. I can get my mouth around most things where I have to stop. But the sensitivity is there quite well. I won't be doing anything naughty, you know, which some of my friends try and cope, let me into doing. I'll be a very good girl for the time being. But so it's actually feeling quite fantastic. Thank you very much.
What do they do with the bits they cut out? Did you keep that?
I've got
a little bottle around your neck or something?
I've actually got that in a jar at home.
In a jar?
So yeah. In case I ever want to get back to doing strides and on stage, I'll just glue it back on with a bit of super glue.
Were you in hospital for long, Taylor?
I was in hospital actually for 2 days. Carissa visited me both days because she's a very sweet sister of mine. And she told me to take Pepidine. Because I'm not really a drug person, as I was brought up by B. Smith, not to lag, not to take drugs, and to bash somebody if they do annoy you. So that's the way it's always gone on. And I took Pepidine once, and I just went bang straight to sleep. It was quite traumatic.
Lovely. Well, if you want to find out more about Tabitha's nose, feel free to ring up. We got to go. We're going to have a we're going to go with a traditional. Oh, showing my sweaty armpit. A traditional gay and lesbian farewell with some peppermint schnapps. Up here, he's looking at
me. And here's to the prisoner party.
Yes. Yes. Absolutely.
Yes. 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 Yes.